All right, continuing our discussion of roots, we're going to talk about how we can estimate roots without a calculator. So if I say find the 10th place digit of square root 6, this is what you can do. Remember what we're looking for. Square root means you're looking for something squared is 6. So for estimating, we want to know something squared as close to 6 as we can get. So you know that 2 squared is 4, 3 squared is 9. So 6 is between 4 and 9. So square root 6 is going to be between square root of 4 and square root of 9. Square root of 4 is what? 2. And square root of 9 is 3. Now we can do 2.1 squared, 2.2 squared, 3 squared, all the way up to 2.9 squared until we get a situation where one number is smaller than 6 and one number is bigger than 6. So that tells us that square root 6 is between 2.4 and 2.5. So square root 6 is going to be 2.4 something. All right, same thing, cube root. Now you're looking for something cubed. We know that 2 cubed is 8, 3 cubed is 27. So 10 is between 8 and 27. So we know our cube root 10 is going to be 2 point something. Again, you can cube 2.1, 2.2, and so on. And you'll notice that 2.1 cubed is this, 2.2 cubed is that. And 10 is between those two numbers. So cube root of 10 is going to be 2.1 something. All right, so in your homework problems, we want you to compare what's on the left-hand column to the row that's here. Okay, we're going to do the first row for you so you know what we're looking for. So when you do your homework, make sure that for each number you have a justification like what we have here for you. So in the for my eyes only column, do some scratch work so you can figure out the logic behind why you're writing what you're writing. So we already know that in exponential notation, 2 to the half, radical notation, square root 2, they're the same. So what sign are we going to put here? Good, equal to. Let's take a look at this. So let's go back in for my eyes only column. So 2 cubed is 8. And square root 2, we already saw, is 1 point something. So square root 2 is smaller than 2, which means that square root 2 is smaller than 8. So that's why they're less than. Square root 2 is bigger than negative 2 squared. Why is that? Because this negative 2 squared, 2 squared is 4, so this is negative 4. That's a negative number, positive number. Positive numbers are always bigger than negative numbers. What about 1 over square root 2? 1 over square root 2 is a fraction with denominator bigger than 1, which means that 1 over something bigger than 1 is point something. And we already know square root 2 is 1 point something. So square root 2 is bigger than 1 over square root 2. How about this? Well, 4 square root 2, which means the same as 4 times square root 2. That's what this means. So square root 2 is 1 point something, right? It's a number bigger than 1. And so that would mean 4 times a number bigger than 1 is going to be more than 4. So clearly, square root 2 is smaller than 4 square root 2. Okay? How about this next one? It doesn't matter what you have here. As soon as you have a negative of something, look what we have. We can rewrite it, negative exponent, same as positive exponent, but you have to do reciprocal. It's negative of, so it's going to stay negative. So negative square root 2. So positive square root 2, negative square root 2. So that would mean what? Bigger than. That's the kind of logic that you have to write explanation for in your notebook when you bring this homework back. And here's the rest of your homework.